Hi everyone, welcome to my first ever video series. So far, my tutorials were only focused on CSS animations. It's time to go to the next level and try some JavaScript. In this series, we will create animated background effects you can use for your website. You saw some of them in the first few seconds of the video. Today I will show you how to create this floating particles effect, and we will build our code so that we can easily transform this into another effect in later videos. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to like if you liked it, subscribe to the channel for more, and click the bell icon to get notified when I release a new video. We will work with three files: index.html, style.css, and script.js. All we need to do in index.html is to link the style and script files and create canvas element with an ID of canvas1. In style.css file, I like to start with basic reset rules so we don't get any unexpected behavior across browsers. I will give the canvas position absolute, width 100%, height 100%, and background will be a linear gradient between three colors. In script.js file, we will start with declaring basic variables to set our canvas up. We grab the canvas element with getElementById and save it to a constant variable I called canvas. Then we create two-dimensional rendering context with canvas getContext2D. We set canvas width to window inner width and canvas height to window inner height. Declare let variable for particle array. We will use this later. Now we want to populate our canvas with particles, so we will use so-called constructor function. These are used if you need a blueprint to create many objects of the same type. Each particle will have position on x and y axis to set its coordinates, direction x and direction y property to set speed, how fast the particle is moving along the axis, size and color properties. Next, we will add the draw method to our particle object. We could also declare this method inside the particle constructor function itself by saying this.draw equals function. However, that is considered a bad practice because it would create a copy of that method for each particle we generate. Instead, we want to place this method directly on the particle prototype. When we call the method and JavaScript interpreter cannot find the method on the particle itself, it will travel down the prototype chain to find it there. This way, each particle is referring to a single draw method, instead of having the draw method in multiple places in our memory for each particle separately, which would cause performance issues. Draw method will draw a single particle on the canvas. We can test it by calling new particle by giving it position x and y 10, direction x and y 1, size 20, and color white. Now I call the draw method. It is not working because I placed the script file before the canvas element in index.html file, so JavaScript cannot find the canvas with getElementById. All I need to do is to put the script file all the way to the bottom of the page. It is not moving yet. We will need to create another method I called update to make it move. Update method is the thing that will be called over and over, frame by frame. Before we draw each frame, we want to check if the particle hasn't reached the edge of the screen yet. If it has, we will switch its direction. I do this with simple if statement, if this.x plus size of the particle is bigger than canvas width, or if this.x coordinate is smaller than 0, we say direction x is equal to minus direction x. If direction x is plus 1, for example, this will switch it to minus 1, and particle will start moving in the opposite direction until it reaches the other end of the screen, and it will switch again. Each particle is basically a slowly moving bouncing ball. We do the same for vertical y-axis, so very similar code, but we are checking for canvas height this time. So if this dot y plus this dot size is bigger than canvas height, or this dot y minus this dot size is smaller than 0, this dot direction y is equal to minus this dot direction y. Once we checked, we draw a particle at its current x and y location by calling this dot draw. Since we want to create many particles, and each will have random size and speed, we need to create an array of objects and declare values for each one. I will create a function that will initialize the array and assign random values to each particle. I'm calling that function init. We have already created particle array variable earlier. Now we assign empty array to it in case it's not empty at the moment. Then we create a for loop. Let's loop through 100 items, and this will create 100 randomized particles. Size will be a random number between 0 and 20. Position x will be random between 0 and canvas width. Position y will be a random number between 0 and canvas height. We will also need to account for our particle size when assigning the initial position to make sure our particles are not stuck in the wall. Both direction x and direction y will be a random number between minus 0.2 and plus 0.2. We want our particles to be moving, to be bouncing very slowly, to look like they're floating in liquid. And for now, let's make all of them white. We can randomize the colors later. Now, I will push this randomized particle object into our particle array. Finally, animation function to get everything moving. I call the function animate, but you can call it whatever you want. I will use request animation frame API and call animate. First, in each frame we want to clear our canvas, otherwise our particles will be leaving trails. Just call ctx.clearRect 00 inner width inner height. This will delete our entire canvas over and over, so it's ready for the next updated draw. Now, for loop that will iterate over the entire particle array length each time and run our update method for each particle. If you remember, the update method first checks if the particle hasn't reached the edge of the screen, and if it hasn't, it will draw it. Now we call init and we call animate. It is not moving. Let's see. Right. One thing I forgot to do, update function also has to update particle position by adding its direction x and direction y values to its x and y coordinates. Now it's all moving nicely. There is one issue though. If you resize the canvas, everything stretches. We don't want this behavior. What we want is to run init again and refill our particles array and calculate positions for each particle within our new canvas dimensions. I will add event listener for window resize event. Each time user changes window size, our canvas will adjust its width and height, and init function will run to redistribute particles evenly across the new available space. Like this. One last thing I want to show you is how easy it is to customize and change this animation. I can just go into our init function and I can change size, color, or number of particles to achieve a different effect. Feel free to play with it and experiment like I did. Anyway, that's all for the first part. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to like the video if you liked it, subscribe for more, and click the bell icon to get notified whenever I release a new video. See you next time.